On me, okay, Aki Kareem for British Boxers. We're here with Josh Warrington, who's back out again on the 21st of October in his hometown of Leeds. I've just had a little interview there with your opponent, Dennis Ceylan.
Dennis the Menace.
Dennis the Menace, yeah. He's an interesting character, isn't he? What did you make of his sort of reverse psychology and antics today?
Reverse psychology, innit?
Reverse psychology.
I studied that shit in sixth form, I know what it's about. The kid's nervous, man. He's nervous. I've seen him in Connery. I took him pictures of all this. I mean, obviously, it's nice to come along and get memories. He's having a little holiday while he's here, but I don't think he's been in anything like this before. He hadn't left his country before. And he's stepping in, not just in front of a big crowd, it's an hostile crowd. If you haven't been to Leeds before...
Oh, I've been there a number of times.
Listen, it's not like anything else. You've got guys there who I've grew up with, hanging over the railings, screaming and shouting. They want him to get hurt because they want me to win so bad. That's what it is. And there's a lot of them in there as well, so that's what it's all about. When it gets to the next press conference and the weigh-in and stuff, I think it might start, cracks start appearing. I mean, I could have laid it on him then, but I want to give him as much opportunities as he needs to make it a good fight. But I don't think he's boxed at anybody my level. And I think, he's in a real hard fight October 21st.
You know, when you get a fella like that, who you think's looking a bit fragile and all that, is it sort of, you go and put it on him straight away, or is it just sort of see what they're doing and react?
We've got our ways of dealing with it. We've got our ways of dealing with things. Obviously, there's shitloads riding up line in the IBF final eliminator. The big ones after this. So we've got many, many ways of dealing with this fight. He's got a couple of inches in me, but no one's going to be able to be as tall as Isashi Amagasi or as awkward as him. He's not going to be as tough as Kiko Martinez or as fit as him. And I've been with all these big punches, and I've never been down, I've never been knocked. So I don't think this guy brings anything that can stop me being IBF mandatory.
Just having a chat with your man as well, and he says he thinks you're a bit more serious today than normal. Is that because you know what's at stake?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. There's a massive amount at stake here, let's not be around the bush, The world title didn't happen, obviously frustrating. So that's just giving me that little bit between the teeth. I've seen a lot of bollocks being shouted on social media.
Seems so wound up.
Oh yeah, I mean, listen, I'm not one to be there. I mean, I'm having a little argument with Ryan Walsh. I've done it in the morning, I've gone training, I've come home, I've had a shower, I've had some food, and I've gone back on it. He's still fucking there, shelping away. People can talk shit, but I'll just talk facts. And at the end of the day, we're trying to make the world title. They're also trying to make it the WBC world title with Joseph Diaz. Final length for that. Never materialised. And here we are. I think the bit between the teeth is just because it's been coming for that long now. I think I just want it that bad. This is the gate, man. This is the gate.
Well, as
I will add to that as well. This is a fucking hard sport, is boxing. People put life on the line, they get hit, and no matter what is taken, you don't do drugs in fucking sport. You don't do drugs, do it after. There's plenty of boys in the arena who'll have a party with you after. Don't do it now. Do you know what I mean? So I give him a little bit of a telling off of that, but I give him a roast in the ring.
Yeah.
I give him a roast in the ring about that.
Yeah, no, I noticed you mentioned that there, and you're within your rights to say it.
It can't be swept under the carpet, can it? I mean, at the end of the day, we're professional athletes. If they're going to break the rules like that, what else are they going to break the rules with? Do you know what I mean? It makes you wonder, but...
Well, listen, man. As you say, you're going to make him pay in the ring, and also with the stuff that's going on with the Lee Selby stuff, I think that's giving you more fire as well to put it on him in there. So, all things considered, he could be in for a very rough night, couldn't he?
Yeah, really? I think so. There's so much riding on it now, The Sasha Amagasas, the Kiko Martinez fights, they mean nothing now. It's all about this one, and this guy's standing in the way of what we've been trying to get to for the last 3 years, so I'm not going to stop now, am I? You know, I'm not going to stop. I've put too much time and effort in training and hard knocks to just crumble here. You know, there's so much riding on it, so you know, I want that Lee Selby fight so bad, so beat this guy. It's on.
All right, well, as always, wish you the very best. Can't wait to the fight. We'll be there to cover it.
Thanks very much.
Josh Warrington, thanks for your time. Aki Kareem, British Boxers.
Cheers.